Morning, everybody. How are you? Rob and I are doing fine. Thank you for asking, because a lot of people are asking, and I think that's very sweet. So we are doing fine. We're still in quarantine, but well, that's just to stay safe, and we want to stay safe, right? Today I'm going to do another pour with only water and paint, and I'm going to add a little something, but I'll show you that later. The colors I'm using is I made a mix of Prussian blue and, let me see, what's this color called? Potato blue. This is from Artina and this is Lucas. And I just mixed that together because I actually wanted only Prussian blue, but I did not have enough paint anymore. The first thing I'm doing is I'm wetting down my brush a little bit with water. And I'm wetting down my canvas a little bit, just a little. And I'm going to do a base layer with just acrylic paint, and that's because when I'm pouring I don't want to see any white canvas coming through. So yeah, that's just, I found out it's easier if you do it like that. But anyway, I'm going to do a base layer of the blue in a minute. And on that, I'm going to put some white. And I'm going to blow out that white. And I was thinking, what if I put in a little bit of pigments on top? Just sprinkle them on top. I never did that, but I wondered how that is going to look. And this is the Bling It Platinum Rose. Very pretty color.
It's upside down.
Yeah, very pretty color. And I was just wondering, well, maybe it will give a nice effect. Maybe not. Maybe all that will happen is that I bury it with my paint. I have absolutely no idea. But I just wanted to try that. And I wanted to keep my pour simple, and that's why I'm only using two colors, only the blue and the white. Well, I won't bother you with me painting that canvas. I will just finish this and I will be back with the pour. Okay, so I've just covered the canvas roughly, and it's not even dry or anything, but now I know I have everything covered. The first thing I'm going to do is to put a layer of those blue paints. So this is how that looks mixed. And that will be our base layer. All my paint is only mixed with water. So this is just water and paint. And on top here, I have a video where I totally explain how I do that mixing, if you are interested. And I'm just going to divide that a little. This thing that you see, it's a kitchen, I think you call that a kitchen utensil or something.
A utensil?
Yeah, I'm not sure. Utensil? I'm not sure how to pronounce that. No, it's used to fry eggs and all that kind of stuff. And I got it from the Wish app. So if you are looking for something similar, just, yeah, look for something that's used in the kitchen. So So, and how are you all doing? Please let me know below the video, because I want to know, I want to chit chat, and I want to know how you're all doing. I really do. Excuse me, the doorbell is ringing. Excuse me for that interruption. That was the mailman. I'm going to pop some bubbles by using a blowtorch or creme brulee torch, as they also call it. Okay. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to make two puddles with white. This is just titanium white from Amsterdam. Let me quick torch that also. And now I'm just going to sprinkle that platinum rose. And for you who are first new to my channel, this is from Color Arte, and I do have a coupon code below, and my coupon code will save you 20% on all pigments and all other art supplies on that website. So it will give you a discount of 20%. I think that's pretty much. And my coupon code is Saskia Smith 120, all lower cases. So I'm just sprinkling on now the platinum rose. And I have no idea, guys, if this will do anything at all, but I just wanted to try. Okay, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to pour the same blue around my puddles. Both puddles. I hope I have used enough white, but we will see. Now I'm getting my hair dryer. This is it. I got it from Wish, but I have put some hair dryers in my Amazon store. Link is below if you're looking for this model. Okay, guys, here we go. Wow, that lacing is just beautiful. Let me see. I'm going to pour a little bit of dark blue here. I'm going to make some just some small adjustments. And I'm going to show you in a minute what the pigments are doing. Here there's not much visible anymore, and here I have a layer, and I'm going to make sure that my edges have paint everywhere. And it will look a little bit messy now, but I will assure you this will dry up perfectly flat, and that's because the paint is mixed with only water. It will just some sort of, yeah, I don't know, be one with your canvas. I'm not sure how to say this in another way. I'm going to blow this out also a little. I think the pigments do give a really nice effect. Just look at that cells. You know what's doing this? The Amsterdam titanium white. Awesome. Okay, I'm going to leave it like this. I'm going to give you a close-up and I will show you once it's dried what it looks like. I'm not sure. What do you think, Arnie?
Because leave it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Do you think that this is white enough?
Leave it.
Okay. I want to blow out that a little bit more.
Leave it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, we're back. As you can see, it's a very subtle painting. And I cannot wait until I see how this will dry. But I do like it very much. But yeah, here's on this side there's only a little bit of pigment there. And here in the white is a little bit. Well, that turns, I don't know, pink. But here we have a beautiful line. I think. And I think this will, yeah, give that little nice extra touch. I hope I can show you this up close. I'm sorry for the glare. But of course, you probably will just see that once the painting is dry. But I really, really love that edge. I think it just is giving this that little something extra. And will you just look at that lacing? Incredible. So now you really can see what that titanium white from Amsterdam really does. And that is, I guess, why they use that Amsterdam titanium white in the bloom technique. Because only that white is creating cells already. Okay, guys. I'm not sure how I would hang it, like this or like this, but I will find that out once it's dry. And okay, I will be back with the dry result. Hi! So my painting is not completely dry, but I love the way that it's drying. And I do want to show you a close-up. So, as you can see, the pigments made a very nice line against the pour, and I really, really love that. Here it's a little bit more messy, but I still love the look, and I don't know if you can see it, but it's really laying on top of the painting, but it is hard. I can touch it, and it will not be on my fingers. I really love the lacing here. And I was a little bit scared in the beginning it would dry a little bit too dark, but it totally has not. I think it dried really beautiful. And you see, I can touch it a little bit, but yeah, it's not completely dry, so I don't want to move it now. And on this side, I only have a little bit of pigment right there. And there's a little bit here in the white. But as you can see, the white is over it, and below that, yeah, it looks like a little mountain of sand. So yeah, we do have some structure now in this painting, so everything will dry totally flat. But where the pigment is, there will be a little bit of structure. But I totally love how this one turned out. So thank you for watching. A lot of items you can find in my Amazon shop. You can find the color art coupon code below my video, SaskiaSmith120, save your 20%. And please visit me on Instagram, on Facebook, on Pinterest. I really love that. And I hope you are all doing very well. See you next time. Bye bye.